Hi, my name is Aimee Shen. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Microbiology and Molecular Genetics at the University of Vermont. My lab studies Clostridium difficile, which is a gram-positive, spore-forming obligate anaerobe that's a leading cause of healthcare-associated infections in the United States. It causes around 500,000 infections per year and leads to around 30,000 deaths. The infections are usually caused after people take antibiotics, which disrupts their normal gut microflora, and that allows C. diff, which is Clostridium difficile for short, allows it a niche to grow in the gut. And that can cause major problems in healthcare settings because there's a lot of people who are taking antibiotics. And we study the spore form of the organism because this is the major mechanism by which the bacterium transmits disease. But spores are really, truly amazing forms of life because they can survive boiling, drying, freeze drying. They've been taken up into space and exposed to the radiation in space, and they still have been able to germinate when they're brought into the right conditions. And so they've actually been designated the toughest form of life on Earth by NASA. And so my lab studies how this bacterium forms this very resistant, metabolically dormant spore form, and then how those spores germinate in the gut to cause infection. So I'm from Edmonton, Alberta, and I went to the University of Alberta for my university, and then I did grad school in the States. And I job shadowed a microbiologist when I was in high school. I had some friends whose parents were professors, and it always seemed really interesting to me how engaged they were in their work and how it was just something they were so passionate about. And I really wanted to find something I was really excited about for, you know, what I wanted to do for my career. I had actually initially thought I was trying to become a medical doctor, but when my first research experience in the lab, it was just really exciting to me that the answer wasn't in the textbook. And then you start realizing, like, you know, the stuff that you're learning in the textbook is based on the research that we're doing in the lab. When I first started doing bench work, I just absolutely fell in love with it. I mean, there's the tactile aspect. I mean, it's sort of like cooking, but, you know, so it's fun just working with your hands, but, you know, the part where you design an experiment and you think, like, what are the right controls? What will allow me to actually answer the question that I'm asking? I really enjoy that aspect, sort of the problem-solving nature of it. And then there's also the troubleshooting, which is less glamorous, but it's really satisfying when you figure out how to really optimize the system and then really be able to set up the experiment so you can get the answer that you're looking for. One of the most fun times in science is when you discover something people had no idea really existed. So one of the things that we've recently discovered is a new regulator of spore germination that's really only found in C. diff and its very closest relatives. And so then it's like this really fun mystery or puzzle-solving series of experiments where we're like, we know this protein is involved in, it's required for germination, but we don't know why. And so what are the series of logical experiments we can do to try and narrow down what it's doing? And so, you know, you have a set of experiments that you can design just like sitting at your desk, and then you go out and execute on those experiments, and you have no idea what the answer is, but you know that the series of experiments that you're going to do are going to give you an answer, or at least an idea of what it's involved in. And that is probably the most exciting time for me. So if you're interested in trying to understand how things work, and your interests are sort of in how do living things grow, divide, and in the case of like pathogens, like how do they cause disease, or how do they survive, I think this is a really exciting career to be in. You have no idea where your science will take you. You're going to meet lots of really interesting people along the way. I think one of the things that people don't necessarily realize is that doing research it's not just being very isolated in the lab. There's a whole community of people. I mean, there's the people that you work with directly, and then you train or that train you. So I think if you're interested in science and you want to understand how things work, I mean, doing research is the perfect marriage of that.